Oh, hello there, viewer. Come in, come in. Have a seat. My name is Ryan, and I will be your host this evening. They say that a picture is worth a thousand words, so today we will take the time to give the pictures found on the internet the words they so deserve. Today's picture will be this piece of art submitted by Average Ash on Twitter. Time to see what sort of a story can be told from it. The picture at hand is quite simple, and I imagine quite alarming to most with a passing knowledge of Sonic the Hedgehog. Seeing any of these bright, colorful characters holding a gun is truly a sight. Except for you, Shadow. And the text proclaiming ENOUGH shows a sense of distaste and a command to stop whatever you're doing. Due to the command to stop, along with the shock value of the family neighborhood Knuckles holding a firearm, this image is likely commonly utilized in response to something that the poster deems unworthy of being posted or simply dreadful, such as a post that references the death of one's favorite anime character. However, as it would happen, this image has been edited, because in the original form of this panel, Knuckles is not saying enough. Rather, he is saying, fortunately, transitioning into the next panel in which he mentions how he came prepared, using the weapon to destroy the door in front of him, since his fists couldn't take down the reinforced door in question. But this only raises more questions than answers, doesn't it? Why was Knuckles breaking down this door? Why does Knuckles have a gun? In order to understand these questions, we must dive into the world of the Sonic Archie comics, also known as the Sonic Extended Universe. This particular panel comes from Sonic's friendly nemesis, Knuckles, written by a man who has attained some warranted ire, Ken Penders. Since I have enough words remaining, you all deserve to know what brought about such ire in myself and the Sonic fanbase towards Ken Penders. In short, Ken Penders was a lead writer of the Archie comics for a long, long time. He sued Sega for copyright infringement for similar characters in Sonic Chronicles: The Dark Brotherhood, then copyrighted all of the characters he created for the comics, which was a whole lot of them. After causing such a stink, Archie Comics kicked him from the writing staff and tried to get the characters back, failed, and due to Penders' vigilance on protecting his intellectual property of Sonic OCs, Archie Comics had to write the Super Genesis Wave, essentially deleting all characters created by Ken Penders and resetting the universe. It was quite the messy breakup, and while it could be argued which side is in the wrong, it's clear to see how his reputation precedes him. But this comes before all of that. Over 10 years before all of that, in fact, back in 1996. Ken Penders is the lead writer and artist of this story, and would be the first of many stories revolving around the echidna that does not chuckle. The story of this one kicks off with Knuckles on the hunt for Archimedes, who is a fire ant. He captured Chaotix a few comics ago, and it would appear that they have been taken to Mount Fate, a giant mountain made by Knuckles' technologically advanced ancestors. After passing through traps, a boulder Indiana Joneses him into a room with seeming exit. He scavenges around to find the technological weapons made by his ancestors and uses it to blow the door wide open, hence the gun. Nice. That provides an explanation to why Knuckles is holding a gun, and while one could discuss the Sonic Extended Universe for far more than 1,000 words, that extends the scope of this picture. Instead, this image comes with its own stories, independent from the hand of Ken Penders. The story of answering a question. Why change the original text from fortunately to enough? Originally, I had planned to wax poetic, discussing how we as a culture have lingered towards negative emotions and perversion of popular culture. I had speculated that perhaps it was simply a silly reaction image made for laughs. But what if it was something more? Ammunition for an assault against someone who was once a friend. A sign to pronounce a revolution against authority. A cry to the heavens. A warning from the heavens. Yes, I had a blast speculating this when the oldest version of the post I could find was from 4chan, which might also explain the intensity of some of those speculations. However, in time, a source was found on Tumblr by user Mushroom Cookie Bears, posting the caption, "New Knuckles reaction image for when you see some damn-ass bullshit on your dash." Poetic. And while none of my speculatory options as to why it was created have necessarily been eliminated, the timing does line up with the rise of what was objectively the worst meme of 2018, Uganda Knuckles. I'll draw my own conclusions, you can draw yours. So in conclusion, what is the essence of this picture? Does the bold, dynamic font used to represent the kchak help to accentuate the gun in his hand? Does the simplicity of the background help to not distract us from the fact that Knuckles the Echidna is brandishing this gun? Apparently so. This has been used as a somewhat wide reaction image, and it's clear that it contains some intrinsic value, or else it might not have ended up here and drawn us in. However, the intrinsic value of the picture is nothing. It's a reaction image, an incomplete thought. You'll never see someone posting this and claiming it to be a piece of art. It's meaningless without context, which, in most cases, is strictly dependent upon what it is reacting to. But then again, what is life other than a string of reactions? The Declaration of Independence was a reaction image to at Great Britain declaring taxation without representation. The invention of the airplane was a reaction image to a tweet from at Gravity tormenting us for falling under its grasp. Sitting down to watch this video was a reaction image to at Boredom, who posted a picture saying it will be 15 minutes until a friend arrives, or a video of algebra class. And the reaction to all of that is... enough.